What's up, guys? I'm back here once again for our classic horror review. And now that December has started, I'm going to be doing a review on a classic Christmas horror movie. And this is definitely one movie that I've heard a lot of people talk about here on YouTube. It's a personal favorite of a lot of people on YouTube. And yeah, I must say that this is definitely one Christmas horror movie that I just have to watch, you know, every year at the beginning of December. I've had this movie for years. And, yeah, I mean, I don't know if I'd call it one of my favorites, but I would say it's one movie that I just always enjoy watching every year. But the movie I'm going to be talking about was released in 1984, and it is Silent Night, Deadly Night. And, yeah, this is the uncut and uncensored DVD that, I actually got, back when it was brand new at Best Buy for, like, $15, and then I remember... the movie went out of print for some time, and this DVD was just going for ridiculous amounts of money. Now that the new Blu-ray has came out, of course, this isn't as expensive anymore. But I do remember back when this DVD was just insanely expensive. But yeah, like I usually do, I'm just going to give a description of the story, and I'll tell you guys what I thought about it. So the movie basically follows a young boy named Billy, and in the first scene in the movie, it's 1971, Christmas Eve, and Billy is 4 years old, I think, and he is going driving with his mother and his father, and are going to this asylum to see his grandfather, and, you know, his grandfather has gotten older, and he has to live in this asylum now because he's just been, you know, he's not right in the head, and when they first get there, the grandfather's just sitting there, you know, he's not looking at them. He doesn't even act like that. He even thinks that they're there. And when Billy looks at him, he's like, Mommy, why isn't he looking at us? And she goes, it's because he doesn't know that we're here. And the doctor who works at the asylum tells them that, you know, he has gotten worse as time has gone on. The grandfather's just gotten worse, and, you know, he doesn't know that the family's there. He can't hear them or whatever. And so the Billy's mother and father go to talk to the doctor in another room, and they leave Billy there alone with the grandfather. And when Billy's alone, the grandfather turns and looks at him, and then he starts acting really, really creepy. He starts talking about Christmas Eve. And he starts telling Billy that Christmas Eve is the most terrifying night of the year, and that if you've been bad this year, then Santa Claus is gonna come and he's gonna punish you. And of course, that really, really freaks Billy out. And then on their way home, you know, Billy is saying that he's scared that Santa's coming on Christmas Eve because he's scared that Santa Claus is gonna punish him. His grandfather said, you know, Santa's gonna punish him, and he's really, really freaked out. And the mother is just trying to calm him down. He also has a little brother who I forget the name of the little brother at this point, but he's just a baby in this scene. But as they drive along, a guy in a Santa Claus outfit ends up robbing a convenience store and shoots and kills the convenience store clerk. And then a little bit later, Billy and his parents, they end up coming across the guy dressed up in the Santa outfit that just killed the store clerk and robbed them on the side of the road, and he's over there with his car, and his car's hood is up, so he's acting like his car is broken down. And right as the father rolls up to the man pulls out the gun and shoots the father and ends up killing him. And Billy jumps out of the car and hides, and when he's hiding next to the road, he witnesses the guy in the Santa outfit pull out his mother from the car, rip open her shirt, and, you know, sexually assault her, and then slit her throat. And from that point on, there's something up with Billy, you know. He's been completely traumatized by this event, and it's basically triggered something in his head. Then you skip to about 4 years later. Billy is 8, and he is in a... he's in a school now, but it's school that's run by nuns. I don't really know the exact name for schools like that, but it's run by these nuns. And in the opening scene, you know, it's close to Christmas, and the children are putting up drawings that they drew of Christmas stuff, and Billy ends up, and this is when you first discover that there's something not right about Billy. He actually draws a picture of Santa Claus with a knife, and he has cut off the head of one of his reindeer. And the nun that's there, her name is Sister Margaret, I believe. She knows that there's something not right about that, so she sends Billy to go to the call her Mother Superior, and she's like the main nun of this school. And you can tell that Mother Superior is very, very strict. You know, she's one of those people, you know, like typical, you know, how you think about nuns, them spanking kids with belts and stuff like that. She's basically that type of nun, and she basically just believes that all Billy needs is discipline. You know, she believes that he needs to be punished, and he needs to learn not to, you know, draw pictures like that. And Sister Margaret, on the other hand, thinks that there's something wrong with Billy, and that he needs help. You know, she can tell that he's an innocent boy that has went through something traumatic, and that it might still be inside him in some way. But as the movie goes on, you do find out that, you see the strictness of the nuns that are there. At one point, Billy walks over to a room, and he looks through the keyhole of the room, and he sees two people that work at the school that they're at, and they're in there having sex. And the Mother Superior, the main nun, she comes over and finds them, and ends up, it doesn't show it, but she ends up whipping the man with his own belt and stuff, and then comes out and tells Billy that what he saw, you know, that they were doing something very, very naughty, and that, you know, they didn't think that they would be caught, but when you do something naughty, you're always caught. And this is sort of, you can kind of tell this sort of puts something in Billy's head as, you know, if you do something bad, you're going to be punished, and you deserve to be punished. You know, as Mother Superior tells him, you know, punishment is good. But as he gets older and stuff, his younger brother is also there in the school with him, and he's I forget how old he is in the film. It never really says how old his brother is, but you know, all the kids at the school think that Billy's just a nutcase, basically. So you can kind of see his alienation from everyone else. But at one point, Mother Superior wants to prove to Billy that, you know, Santa Claus is not going to hurt him, and she does this by having a Santa Claus there at the school, and tries to get Billy to sit on Santa Claus's lap. And of course he freaks out about this, and then he runs up to his room, and he thinks that he's being wrong for doing this, you know. And they do some other things. At one point, you know, he has a nightmare, and he runs out of his room, and then the nun ties him up to his bed and stuff. Kind of messed up stuff in a way, and you can kind of see how Billy turns out. You can really tell that he's been through a lot of traumatic stuff, and then he's being told that, you know, having dreams and going out of his room is being bad and being naughty and stuff like that. Well, you can tell he stays there at the school for basically the rest of his life. I believe it's a school, you know, he has beds and stuff like that, and the children basically stay there for however long until they become adults. And then the movie cuts to Billy is now 18 years old, and the Sister Margaret is now the Mother Superior of the school, or one of the Mother Superiors of the school, and she is trying to get Billy a job at a toy store. And Billy is now 18 years old, and from the point he starts working there, he does a great job. The owner of the store really likes him, and everybody in the school in the store really, really likes Billy being there, and he's really a great worker. But unfortunately, as Christmas gets closer, something happens that ends up making Billy snap in a way. He has to put on a Santa Claus outfit and be the Santa there at the store. And while this is happening, one of his co-workers, they're having a Christmas party, and one of his co-workers ends up trying to rape this girl that also works at the store that Billy likes, and this just sends him off, and he ends up going on a rampage, basically to punish people that he thinks are doing bad or doing wrong. You know, punish the naughty, as he calls it. And the entire film is him just trying to punish people that he looks at as being very, very naughty. And that's, you know, as far as I'll go with that. Now, my thoughts on the movie. A lot of people, I think, consider this a typical slasher film in some way. I actually do not think it is. I think that it's got a lot more to it. It's more of a psychological horror film because it shows Billy as just a young boy and he goes through this traumatic event. And then you see him grow up and you see how it never leaves him. And you can kind of see him go at sort of descent into madness or descent into, you know, becoming a killer in a sort of way. And out of all the characters in the movie, I'd say that Billy is probably one of the only really likable characters in the film. You know, you kind of relate to Billy. You relate to him going through this horrible event, and you know that he just wants to be a good person. And throughout the entire movie, he wants to be a good kid. That's the whole point. You know, don't be naughty. And he just gets pushed so much by, you know, of course, the nuns at the, you know, the nuns at the school, and people just being bullying him around and treating him wrong because they think that there's something wrong with him, and then he finally just snaps and gets his revenge. And, you know, I think that that's something that a lot of people can relate to, you know. And, you know, there's a couple of other characters that I say are kind of likable. The mother, or the sister Margaret character, I also like her, but for the most part, Billy is the only really decent person in this whole movie, you know. And it's funny because he's the one that's going around killing, and you know, this is one movie where you can kind of relate to the killer of the film. There's some good funny parts into this movie as well. Like there's one point where during the Christmas party at the store that Billy worked at, this is a funniest scenes. The store owner closes the door up and he says, "Yes, we're finally closed. It's over. Time to get shit faced." And that's just one scene that I think when I first saw it, it really made me laugh. That scene's so funny. I also see one of my favorite YouTubers, Horror Show 3000, aka Richard. He put that clip at the end of his videos, and I just always laugh whenever I see it. And yeah, so Silent Night, Deadly Night is definitely a great horror film to watch, you know, around Christmas time or not. I remember renting this back when I was very, very young. It was the R-rated version, of course. And I was never a huge fan of it until later on. I'm a bigger fan of it now than I was when I was younger. And like I said, it's not one of my favorite films, but it's definitely a really, really good one. And I definitely recommend everyone to check this one out if you guys haven't seen it. It's definitely a great, Christmas horror film. If you're interested and you want something new to watch horror-related around Christmas time, this is definitely one to check out. Also, this is the uncut version, and if you guys know anything about the movie, the quality of the uncut scenes in it are really, really bad because they had to get it from an uncut VHS. And so when the Anchor Bay put this DVD out, when they put the scenes back in, you can really tell what was in the R-rated version and then what they added in, because the scenes of all the gory death scenes are very, very bad quality. And they pretty much cut out every single gory scene in the entire movie, you know? So you can really tell, what has been cut out of the original movie, and it's mostly all the really good gore scenes. And there's some great, great gore effects in this movie. I won't spoil anything, but there's some really, really good ones. And, also I know that there's a new 30th anniversary Blu-ray out. I have not seen it, but I've been told by some reviewers, for anybody that's interested and wants to maybe pick it up, I've been told by some reviewers that the quality of it is not that great. I think that the picture quality is a bit better than this DVD, but not by a long shot, which I'm sure is probably a disappointment to some people that really want to see this movie on Blu-ray. I mean, that's just what I've heard. You know, I don't have it, so I really don't know, but that's what I've heard. And I've also heard there's only one new special feature, which is a commentary by some of the people who worked on the film. So, Silent Night, Deadly Night, definitely a great killer Santa Claus type film, good psychological horror film, and it's definitely one that, you know, if you're a fan of you're looking for something new horror movie to watch on Christmas, I highly recommend this one. Anyway guys, thanks for watching my review for Silent Night, Deadly Night. I'm going to be doing a couple more reviews on some of my favorite, you know, Christmas horror films. I got maybe three more reviews, and the last one is going to be more of a family-friendly Christmas, not horror, but more of a Christmas creature movie. But anyway guys, thanks for watching. If you guys have seen Silent Night, Deadly Night, definitely let me know what you guys think about it as well. I know it's a big, you know, I know a lot of people know about it, but anyway guys, thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys later.